My name is Zoe and you are watching the second episode of Doodles of the Ancients. I very much hope you guys enjoyed. If you have any questions or suggestions which hero I should draw next, feel free to drop them in the comments below. Once more, I'm going to use my Intu's Wakekim 4 and also Photoshop CS 5 to draw the whole thing. And I very much hope you guys enjoyed and thanks a lot for tuning in.
Once more, start my drawing on grey. Now I'm choosing the brushes from Darken, you can download them in the internet. I'm going for one which slightly fades out on the sides and putting them 3 pixel size. Now I'm going to go for the spine again. So it's just like this first stroke, which is technically the spine of the character. Adding the head, really rough, as well as one of the legs and the hips and then the second arm. This is just how I define how the character is going to jump, as he's going to be mid-air. Now we're going to split the head into half, taking a third and another third. The first line is going to be to determine where the eye is, very roughly. The second one is for the nose, as you can already see, and the third line is going to be for the mouth. Normally the ear is between the eye and the nose, however, because the character is slightly angled and he's also some sort of orcish character, that's not really applying since it's fantasy, you know, it doesn't have to work. It's, by the way, the best excuse you can have if you draw anything out of proportion. It's like, oh no, it's fantasy, like, the arm is supposed to be only half as long as the other one. There. I'm going for the hair. I slightly exaggerate it at the moment, and I know that the Dota 2 model of him doesn't really have that long hair. I'm gonna decide if I keep it or not a bit later on, but for now I'm gonna keep it. Now we're just gonna add some meat onto the character. As you can see, I start off with a stick figure, which is basically how you should start off any character, so you keep it in proportion and just get an idea of the stance, and everything about it. So now we can add details, and my cat is joining us too. It's little Mellow. Hello, Mellow. Actually, her name is Gooey Marshmallow, but yeah. Yeah, back to the character. Our second step again is going to be adding some detail to the drawing. So we're just going to go with black and just define it a little bit more so it's a little bit less scribbly. Still does not have to be perfect. We're going to drag a picture of Axe into our drawing, and then just with the color picker tool we're going to steal the colors so we just roughly get the same ones as the one in the picture. If you can see, if I make a line, it's first going to be not 100% opacity, even though I have 100% on the top. However, this is because of the brush. It's basically just like the pressure defines the opacity, so the harder I press onto my graphic tablet with my pen, the darker it gets. It's just the way I prefer it, you don't necessarily have to go for that one. See, I'm using the liquify tool fairly often. I just use it if something is out of proportion or I just want to bend it a little bit and feel like it's not right the way it is. The liquify tool is one of many tools in Photoshop you can use for that. You can also use some sort of transformation tool, which also can work really well depending on what you prefer. I'm gonna go very Asian-ish. It's gonna be like this sunset kind of thing to make it look very Japanese. And once more, I'm gonna go for a stroke for the outlines, setting on I think 5 pixels should be fine, 5 to 6, whatever you prefer. And then I'm gonna use the eraser tool to put it back in form, because as you can see, it's not very straight and it doesn't look very neat. So I'm gonna neaten it up a little bit, and that should work for now. The outlines around it I could do with a stroke, however the ones inside the character I have to do by hand, so that's going to take a while now, and you're just going to enjoy watching. And since everything already looks so Japanese, starting from his hairstyle going to the background, I go for the speech bubble in a very Japanese manner too. I'm not sure if I should spoiler what it says. Nah, it's gonna go, he's just yelling bacon, because I like bacon. That's it. That's all the reasoning I need. This time I'm also going to go for a white stroke on top of the black stroke I already did, just because it looks nice and I decided that I want it that way. With this episode, I very much hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments below and I will try to answer them as good as I can. I very much hope you guys enjoyed it. Not sure if I said that already, and goodbye.